大家好，欢迎来到香港中文大学物理系。我们的课程提供四大力学，即是经典力学、统计力学、电动力学和量子力学。这四大力学的教学之外，亦都会提供各种选修科，例如说是天文学或者气象学。同学除了在读这些基础的物理之外，亦都可以去找教授去做不同方面的研究。我们物理系和很多尖端的科研都有关系，譬如说双拉钩和大亚湾的中微子实验，这些都是一些很顶尖的实验来的。而如果大家有留意新闻的话，会知道是2017年的诺贝尔奖得奖的就是重力波研究。而重力波的研究全香港只有我们香港中文大学是跟 LIGO 有合作的。所以如果同学对各方面研究有兴趣，包括天文或者其他方面的物理有兴趣的话，一定要多些留意我们中文大学物理系。那事不宜迟，我现在就带大家看看我们的 Central Lab 有什么仪器啦。
首先是 Central Lab 的部分，这部分就交给物理系的李生和大家讲解啦。
首先介绍一下啦，这部这么大部机，它是一部作为一个精度一些材料上落个机座上高的一部这样的机来的。那它呢就是通过电子速冲击的材料，那这些材料呢金属又得非金属又得这样的。那将它在那些高能的电子速冲击下面呢，那那些材料呢就会离开它那个靶那里呢，就会蒸到它那个 sample 上高的了。在个样品的上高就会形成了一层薄薄地的一层膜，那这层膜就由各种材料组成的。那这个虽然有很多方法都可以做，那譬如最普通的加热就已经可以蒸到了，但是这部机用电子速去蒸到的好处就是说它可以很精细地控制个镀层的厚度，就去到纳米数量级的。通过反复地蒸到不同的材料上去，我们的测试的样品上就可以在上面蒸了不同的材料了，可以是交替地蒸上去，是以纳米来做一个准确度的。咁啊，啱啱嚟講咧，我哋見到前面嗰度嗰部機咧，就蒸啲金屬或者非金屬嘅材料啦。咁啊，當然啦，我哋首先要知道佢嘅基材，即係個基底係啲咩材料，咁啊有啲特性要分析嘅。咁啊，對於一啲晶體嘅一啲材料咧，咁我哋就需要用呢部機去做。咁呢部機叫做咩咧 ？X-ray 粉末遠射儀，光源咧就係一啲 X-ray 嚟嘅。通過佢照射落去樣品上高咧，咁我哋知道喺轉到某個特定嘅角度嘅時候咧，咁佢就會有啲遠射嘅峰值走咗出嚟啦。咁呢啲遠射峰咧，即係唔同嘅角度出嚟嘅信號咧，就我哋就可以知道呢個樣品咧，佢係屬於邊種晶體結構，或者嚟講咧，係甚至我哋知道佢係邊種材料嘅晶體所組成嘅。咁啊，啱啱我哋介紹完嗰部 X 光嘅粉末顯射儀啦，咁但係咧佢嘅唔好處咧就只能夠做一啲一塊一塊嘅材料或者一啲粉末嘅材料。咁但係對於我哋正話蒸度嘅辦法，蒸上去一啲薄膜咧，正話我哋提到嘅 XRD 咧就有少少力不從心啦。咁我哋呢個時候咧就需要呢部比較大型少少嘅小角度 X 光散射儀。咁呢個上高咧，我哋通過一個好窄好精準嘅 X 光嘅光速咧，就照落啲薄膜度咧，咁就可以知道啲薄膜入边嘅，譬如个薄膜嘅厚度啦，薄膜嘅结构啦，通过呢部机咧，我哋可以得出个结果嘅。咁啊，正话我哋已经介绍咗有几部仪器咧，就可以做到啲晶体嘅结构分析啦。咁但系如果再去到纳米层面上高咧，即系好细嘅区间入边嘅金属晶体或者其他嘅晶体结构咧，咁正话嗰两部机就冇乜能力啦。咁我哋咧就要用呢部叫做透射式电子显微镜咧，就系话通过一个好幼好幼嘅电子束，佢嘅光速咧就去到纳米以下嘅，个波长都去到纳米以下，照射落去个样品上高咧，咁佢就可以好局部性地將細嘅區間入面嘅晶體粒子嘅結構咧分析出嚟。咁同時呢部機仲可以做翻一個成分嘅分析，因為佢本身咧都附帶咗一個 EDX 能譜損失儀。 呢部機咧係一個叫 PPMS 物理特性測量綜合系統，佢最主要就係提供咗一個超低温嘅環境啦，差唔多去到絕對零度啦，4K 去到由2K 多少少，一路去到我哋嘅室温，佢亦都提供咗一個好強嘅磁場喎，就變咗係可以去到14个特斯拉啦。咁14个特斯拉係幾多咧？咁我舉個例子啦，如果一般嘅好強嘅一個磁鐵下面咧，咁呢啲永久磁鐵咧都係講緊0.5个特斯拉左右嘅啫。咁如果將我哋嘅樣品擺咗落去咧，提供一個低温同埋一個強磁場環境咧，我哋就可以度出喺呢啲環境下面嘅各種材料嘅特性啦。我哋做完呢啲嘢咯，咁啊有時好多時候咧，往往喺物理方面嚟講咧，除咗淨係一層表面咧，可能都唔夠喎，因為只係一個二維方向喎。咁點算咧？我哋就要利用呢部機啦。呢部咧係一個雙速裝置嚟嘅，除咗佢係兼帶有一個掃描嘅電子顯微鏡之外咧，佢仲帶有一個聚焦嘅離子束嘅咁樣嘅離子源。好處係咩咧？就話我哋可以通過實時咁觀察一個喺納米附近一個尺度嘅一個圖像嘅時候咧，同時我哋通過一個聚焦嘅離子束咧，就會喺上高咧做一啲精雕細作功夫，改變佢嗰個表面嘅形貌咧。通過呢樣嘢咧，我哋就可以經過一個三維結構上高咧，我哋做一啲其他嘅物理嘅實驗。
聽完 CentralLab 嘅部分，相信大家一定意猶未盡噶啦，仲想聽多啲？冇錯，接下嚟嚟到 Research Lab 嘅部分，等 Professor 同埋研究生同大家揭開中大物理研究室嘅神秘面紗啦。
Hello， 大家，我哋呢度咧就係個 Gravitational Wave Lab。咁我哋其實咧就係研究重力波。咁重力波咧就係時空個嗰啲 ripples 嚟，震嚟。咁我哋呢個 lab 咧，我哋就係一個 virtual lab 嚟嘅。我哋用好大啲電腦 clusters 嚟 simulate 兩個黑洞相撞。我哋亦都係由我哋美國個探測器嚟 download 啲 data， 跟住咧啲 data 就用好大啲電腦嚟揾，睇下我哋見唔見到重力波。
Hi, I'm Huabai Li. I'm the leader of the CHK Star Formation Group, and we try to understand how stars are formed from the Milky Way. And here in CHK, we'll build our own instrument, and we try to install the instrument on a telescope like this, situated either in Chile or Hawaii. And with the instrument, we are going to observe the star formation site. In particular, we observe magnetic field,and turbulence from the star forming site. And then we bring this data, we try to put the data into a computer cluster and perform simulation like this. So we can see the evolution of the star formation site, and from which hopefully we can get some idea how the star can form from Milky Way.
好啦，咁我哋而家就開始介紹我哋呢個實驗啦。中間我哋呢個儀器咧叫做 APRO， 咁佢將會擺喺夏威夷一個天文望遠鏡叫 JCMT 度嘅。咁因為天文望遠鏡咧，我哋擺上去咧係做一啲偏振嘅觀察。咁我哋要知道呢個儀器究竟個效率係點啊，做唔做到嘢啊？咁我哋就需要喺放咗天文望遠鏡之前做一啲測試。呢一邊咧就係出一個 signal。同埋出一個 noise 嘅，因為我哋喺天文觀測入面咧，我哋望上天咧，其實除咗有我哋要嘅嗰個 object 啦，或者可能係 star， 可能係 nebula signal 之外咧，我哋仲會有好多好多 background 嘅 noise。咁嗰啲 noise 咧，嗰啲噪音咧係嚟自於可能大氣層啊，或者係可能佢背後 foreground background 嘅一啲 noise 嘅。咁我哋用呢嚿嘢咧，就係用嚟模擬一個好大嘅 noise 同一個好細我哋要嘅 signal。咁經過 APRO 去改變咗佢偏振角度之後咧，就會嚟到後面呢個 camera 啦。咁我哋呢個 camera， 因為我哋睇到嘅光咧都係非可見光，咁你肉眼睇唔到。咁咧呢度咧就係我哋見到嘅一個 signal 啦。咁咧佢嘅 signal 咧就你見到啦，喺中間咧會有一個類似圓形啦。咁因為佢經過咗之後咧，佢個 signal 弱咗啦，咁喺邊邊有啲唔清楚。當我哋旋轉呢個半波片嘅時候咧，你會發現咧佢個 signal 咧就會隨住個半波片嘅旋轉咧而改變。就當個半波片嘅角度同埋光嘅角度咧係相約嘅時候咧，咁佢就會有一個大啲嘅或者叫高啲嘅 signal 啦咁樣。
Hello everyone, I'm Swigo from the Department of Physics. My group works on strongly correlated electron system under extreme conditions. So there's some pictures here. So basically, to put it simply, we look at how the electrons behave in a piece of solid. And to study how these electrons behave in the solid, we examine the material under extreme conditions. And these extreme conditions are high pressure, low temperature, and high magnetic field. So the idea is we want to find out how to optimize the properties of these materials, and hopefully in the future we can have a more powerful or better materials for application. So if you're interested in our lab, I invite you to have a virtual tour. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My lab is called Nanoparticles and Nanophotonics. We mainly make all kinds of different metal nanoparticles, then study their optical properties, so-called plasma resonance. The purpose for making these nanoparticles and studying them is to try to make optical circuits as small as the electronic circuits. Also, these nanoparticles can be used to harvest sunlight, solar energy, also for ultra-very sensitive sensing, detecting many different molecules.
欢迎大家来到 Tollen 原子分子物理实验室，温度呢大概在负九 Kelvin， 就很接近绝对零度了。因为在这么冷的温度下面呢，这个原子它们的运动速度非常的慢，你甚至可以把它们囚禁起来。研究的时间越长呢，就会看到它们越多的细节。那在这么冷的温度下面，原子的分子它们之间的相互作用呢，会展现出量子力学的特性。其实现在呢，大部分超冷物理的实验都是用超冷原子来做的。但这边这个实验室呢，我们是想要把超冷物理从原子拓展到分子。做的这个方法呢，就是说，因为我们可以做超冷原子，对吧？所以我们把两种原子混合在一起，然后把它们闭合在一起，就可以形成一个分子。这个系统比较可以方便的看到激光冷却的钠原子，还是可以看玻璃腔的这个中间有一个小亮点，一两个毫米，这是激光冷却的钠原子。
Our lab focus on using NV centers in diamond for quantum experiments. One is about some spin-spin interaction in NV center. We have a confocal setup here, and we can observe the spectrum of the NV center. Secondly, will be about spin buff driving using NV center. This coil is responsible for producing a 3D magnetic field. We will understand more about the energy levels or other detailed structures of spins surrounding the NV center.
We can do some low temperature measurement. We have this cold station machine, which is a very expensive machine. So we can measure some material properties such as superconductivity from a material sample using our sensing method, which is NV center negative measurement.
就是现在这个平台是一个用来做传统光刻的一个平台。如果你要操纵 NV 色星的电子自旋状态的话，你需要向它去用一个波导结构去向它传输特定频率和特定偏振方向的微波。
大家好，现在你们所看到的这个平台主要是用于一些磁性材料性质的研究。从这边你们可以看到，这是一台光谱仪，我们可以用它来看到一些材料的荧光光谱。然后在这边是一个比较传统的测量磁性材料的方式，我们可以测量磁性材料的磁质回线，还可以对一些磁性结构进行成像，比如说磁稠、稠壁，这些都是可以进行很快的成像，还可以探究它们的超快动力学的性质。
这个平台主要是我们组一个做量子计算的平台，我们这个平台主要是研究钻石里面的碳13的一些核自旋的性质。如果我们使用在 钻石里面的碳十三作为量子资源的话，它的相干时间可以达到几个毫秒。
Welcome to this virtual tour of our lab. Our lab works on physics of living systems. We are interested in non-equilibrium systems and biological self-formalization. Our ultimate goal is to understand how living things arise from non-living things. And in the past few years, we have made an array of discoveries about the collective motion and self-organized behavior in microbial communities. We are pushing forward the boundary of biological self-organization and hope the knowledge will be used to advance the field of non-equilibrium physics as well as active matter engineering.
今日嘅 lab tour 就到此为止，希望各位同学睇得开心啦。如果你有兴趣嘅话，记得留意我哋香港中文大学物理系嘅网页。拜拜。